So in this video, we're going to discuss undeposited funds and deposits. Now, undeposited funds is use that account when you hold checks and cash payments that you're collecting for future deposits. As you collect the checks and cash, you can enter these payments into Intacct even though you don't know when you'll make the deposit or to what bank. So for example, say you make deposits on Fridays, but you collect payments throughout the week and you need to record them in Intacct. The payments are correctly accounted for in the undeposited funds account, but the deposit has not actually been made to the bank yet. That is made once you create an actual deposit in Intacct, in cash management, or in AR, where you have the same functionality. Now, we previously saw undeposited funds account when we were looking at the other receipts. We came in here to create one. We saw that you have undeposited funds here. In AR, you would see that whenever you go to receive payments, you'll have the chance to choose between a bank account or undeposited funds account. Okay? As you can see, we don't yet have that account set up. But we may need to do that before we continue on, don't you think? Now that we're set up properly, let's go in and make an undeposited funds transaction. We'll go to other receipts because I don't want to go to AR yet because we have a whole nother module that'll cover that. So we'll go to other receipts. A payer is going to be, since I'm sitting at my computer, it's going to be QWERTY. We'll have transaction date of today. We'll do an undeposited funds. It goes to our undeposited funds account. We'll choose a location. Okay, we'll choose an account, revenue other in this case, let's say it's 1400. And we'll click save. Now, in order to move this out of the undeposited funds account, we would have to make a deposit. When you receive payment on invoices, AR advances, or in cash management, other receipts that go to the undeposited funds account, you'll create the deposit to record the payments, and you can do this for multiple customers in one deposit. In this case, we're only going to have one transaction, but you could use it for any number of customers, and you make just one deposit off of that. So we come here to deposits, add, we'll choose the bank account we want it to go to, then deposit funds, date, the payer, in this case, is you don't have to put in payer, but I am because what we have, you don't have to do any of this currently, but we're going to right here, we'll do continue. If you have any transactions in the undeposited funds, it'll show up here. Otherwise, it'll tell you, hey, there's nothing here for us to deposit. So you come down here, you'll select what the funds that you want to deposit, and click Save. Notice I didn't choose Customer because I didn't have an actual customer. So now that is in there. Let's click View. See, we have it functioning. Come over here to Registers. You can come to Deposits. Current month, blah, 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 click view. Whoops, customize. I've got to choose the correct bank. Now click view. And there we go. Don't worry about the in transit. Until it's reconciled, it's going to say in transit. We can also come to the bank. Let's choose the proper bank this time. Click view. And there we go. There's our little deposit here, right? And that's all there is to the deposits and undeposited funds. Some people have a hard time getting their head around undeposited funds because it doesn't make sense. I can understand why you wouldn't deposit funds as soon as you get them, but some people don't. So for that, we're done, and let's move on to our next section.